the being descended from Mayan ruins. Larry Hoover's finest, the Malcolm X of the music. And walking in your purpose, then why you walking, you useless.
Hi everybody, this is Sugar Moon, also known as Cheyenne. I hope you guys are all having a beautiful day and night wherever you guys may be in the world, and I hope you guys are taking care of your energy as such. Today's topic is, they claimed that you were crazy when really you were not.
I said, wait a minute.
Okay, so this is going to be a very interesting topic, okay? They claimed you were crazy in order to ruin your reputation, to discredit you, but really you are not. So, before we dive in, I would like to give a quick thank you and shout out to people who are now joining the Sugar family. Yay, your presence here is so much appreciated. Thank you. All your guys' wonderful comments, especially on the last few readings that I've done, like, shout out to you guys. Thank you so much for, like, commenting, liking, as well as joining the Sugar fam and everything like that. I am immensely grateful that this channel is now growing. We have reached over 600, I believe, since the last time I checked. And it got me thinking that maybe I should do something special for everyone when we reach 1K in the future. You know what I mean? So I'll try to come up with something, because you guys definitely are awesome. Most part, I'm just wishing you all a beautiful night. And so let's get into this. We all know that when we're starting off on the spiritual awakening, or people start having activations going on, you're going to start sounding a little bit crazy to people. Now, what I mean by that, it means that you are starting to sound otherworldly, or there's some sort of disconnect when it comes to vibration. You know, because there's only certain things that a person can understand at a certain point, right? Because everybody's at different points consciously, right? And we're all learning, we're all expanding as we go. The goal is to aim for growth, for ascension. But essentially, we run into people, I'm talking about lower vibrational people, who don't have any intentions of growing, but when they see other people being themselves, when they start seeing people acting authentically, there's something that triggers within them as far as ego goes, where they start comparing themselves to you, right? And it's like this cycle that just trickles down to someone wanting to put you down and discredit you as crazy. So you could be somebody that speaks a lot of truth.
It's God's side and the other side. And we don't care nothing about the other side. Period. All of these big dick deviants is all catching hell in 2024. It's up for all of them. It don't matter if you Diddy or whoever you is, T.G. Jakes, any of them, all lies will be exposed. That's all. And anyone who takes that the wrong way, know why they take it the wrong way. The truth is the light.
I need to have no more of these.
Amen.
Gee.
You could be somebody that going through a spiritual awakening now, or you've already been on the journey. You're someone that likes to share what you've learned, right? But sometimes you come into the situations where you're sharing these things to someone, and then they give you a blank stare.
Go crazy! Go stupid! Ah!
And you're like, the fuck? Like, are you even listening to me? You know what I mean? And chances are, you know, some people do mean well and they're trying to understand you, but while they may not understand your viewpoint, they're still willing to listen. Kudos to those types of people. Those are really good support, but even though they may not understand exactly what you're talking about, right? They're still advocates for you. I'm talking about people who are willing to gaslight you in some form. It's like a form of manipulation at its finest. And one thing that a narcissist or someone that is on lower vibrational energy likes to do is that they like to minimize and keep you small in any way. Sorry, everybody, I had to walk away for a little bit and tend to my son. But as I was saying, continuing, so is that people who essentially want to make sure that you are not listened to, or to discredit you, or to make other people Because that's what I say. Let's just rewind. I stated this before in a previous reading, that if they cannot get to you in any way, if they cannot ruin your mood, if they cannot hurt your feelings, whatever it may be, then they go to the other route, which is to go to other people who may be close to you or even complete strangers. And their goal is to tarnish your reputation by calling you crazy. Now, the thing is that the term crazy is just a label, first of all, right? But let's be real, you're not crazy, all right? The things that you're going through, the feelings and emotions that you've dealt with, even the reactions that you may have, you know, resulted in abuse, because right, reactive abuse is also a thing where someone pushes you so hard to the point where it takes you out of character. Have you ever been in that situation where you've dealt with very lower vibrational people, whether it be friends, family, lovers, ex-lovers, and everything like that, where they poke and poke and poke at you until the point where you react?
You hungry? Oh, maybe you should go into the kitchen and get yourself something to eat there, huh? Christina! Christina's gone!
I'll remind you, as somebody who has also been through this before, we are responsible for our actions. And while it may not be okay for reactive reactions such as that to be extreme, there's no excuse for that. But at the same time, as somebody who understands the victim standpoint of being pushed that far to the point where you start going into a psychosis type of mode, yes, to everybody on the outside, it may seem like that person is crazy, but no, that person has been emotionally abused and broken down to the point where they finally have an outburst of emotions, and it was reactive towards whatever abuse that may have been taking place. So, in a way, there has to be some sort of understanding on that viewpoint. But again, I always say that we're all responsible for our reactions of things. And the best reaction to these people is to not give any reaction at all, which is to walk away. And I know how hard that may be, because in that moment, a fit of anger, you would want to be heard. You want to get your words out. And trust me, there will be a time where you'll be able to share your story, to be able to speak your truth. But remember, we must choose our battles wisely in life. And everything is a choice, and our choices have consequences within this universe. And I find that when you stonewall, or when you completely shut down or shut down access of yourself to these folks,
look. عارفاها بلوك على الفيسبوك بلوك على الواتساب بلوك تليفونات بلوك انستغرام بلوك 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 بلوك
that in time usually the divine will clear your reputation to everyone who was affected, because really truth of it all will come out and will prevail. What goes down in the dark will always come to the light regardless, you know. And so if there are lies being spread about you, if your reputation is being tarnished in any way, and people are discrediting you and calling you crazy merely because of the fact that you are going through an awakening process, or your mind or consciousness is now expanding to a level where they cannot understand, just know that there is nothing wrong with you, and that the people surrounding you who's making their mission to ruin your reputation as such, there's something that needs to be fixed within them, okay? Now, what they say has nothing to do with you. What stories they come up with is none of your business. Spirit wants you to stay focused and to stay diligent in continuing on your journey and walking your path. Okay, so do not pay these folks any mind. as far as those who want to claim that you are crazy, that are aiming to change other people's viewpoints of you merely because they dislike you or dislike what you're saying or disagree with what you're saying, completely walk away. All right? Because you don't want to rack up karma yourself in the meantime. You know, if you were to continue to entertain that mess, right? Because there comes a point where spirit wants us to close that chapter and to learn to completely leave it alone and leave it in the past and move forward. But that's up to you. Okay? But I'm here to remind you, you are not crazy. And if you have come in situations where people have literally spoke ill of your name, who have called you loony or just out there or just crazy and don't listen to her or him, she or he don't know what they're talking about and things like that, they're mental and they need to go to a mental hospital, that type of thing. So chances are a lot of these people who are calling you crazy, putting you in situations where you would be into a mental hospital situation. And this is coming from somebody who has been in a mental hospital, who has been in that journey. Most of those people that were in there most likely were going through a spiritual awakening of some sort, you know? It's just that people are not at that level right now. Society's not at that level to truly understand what these symptoms may mean. So this is a little bit of a shorter topic. I'm going to go ahead and end this here. I am filming this pretty late, so I just wanted to, before going to bed, I just wanted to stop you off with this message, right? Because I feel like somebody needed it. I felt like somebody was questioning themselves, like, maybe I am crazy. Maybe I am tweaking. And you might be somebody who is going through a Kundalini awakening or some sort of dark night of the soul moment. And I remember those days because we have several, right, throughout a lifetime. But I remember, man, going through the ringer with the first rounds, right? Those are probably the most hardest moments. And my heart goes out to you. But I'm here to also confirm to you, you are not crazy, okay? Now, the thing is that I always say to people, before you start self-diagnosing yourself, make sure that you go get checked out first. Go to a doctor. Hey, even go to therapy if you need to, right? If you feel like you really need it, there's nothing wrong with that. If you need to talk to somebody, please do so. If you feel like you're getting frustrated and you don't know who to turn to or talk to, please seek help if you need that, you know, or further guidance. I always advocate for that. But also realize that if anybody is even calling you that term, you know, even if you're hearing somebody, it even boils down to if you're in the dating scene and that person keeps claiming that their exes are crazy, run. Run.
Oh, hell no!
Absolutely run, okay? Because that lets you know that that person doesn't know how to take any form of accountability on their part, right? And that's really truly what it is. Either somebody will claim that you're crazy because they feel called out and that they are afraid to take accountability for whatever issues that they have may cause into the mix, or it could mean that they don't agree with what you're saying, and for some reason what you're saying is making them irritated in some form, so they have to discredit you and call you crazy. It really just depends on the situation at hand. It's not a nice term, you know? Words are spells. I keep saying that to people. So be careful on even calling yourself crazy, you know, because we have people out here that be saying it as if it's a great attractive trait, saying, yeah, I'm crazy, bitch. Like, you know, don't mess with me. It's just like, I don't think you should be using those words, but hey, that's up to you. You do you, boo. You do you, but I'm just here as a warning, you know, be careful on the words that you speak out here in this world. You can manifest exactly what you put out there. I'll leave you with that, though. Like, my heart goes out to you. Just know that you're on the right path. You're good. You're Gucci. You're just trying to figure things out, right? And just go at your own pace. So let me know if this resonates. Go ahead and leave comments below. Have you ever been called crazy for whatever reason, right? Go ahead and share those stories, because for me personally, I have been called crazy in every fucking situation you can think of. So I just wanted to get on here and just be like, yo, I know I'm not the only one out here dealing with this type of bullshit, right? And usually the people who are truly gifted, usually the people who are very in tune, are called crazy the most. Isn't that funny? It's ironic. So, wishing you guys all well. Love you. Peace.